So before I get into the official intro here, I just want to say real quick to please like this video if you guys don't mind. It helps spread the word, helps get the video in the algorithm, and use the hashtag FixMW. Spread it across social media and make your voice heard here, because this is something very serious and I don't want to see Modern Warfare just completely butchered like this. It's not right. It's just not right at the end of the day. So let's get on to the video now. What's going on, guys? Bleem Truth here, the Godfather himself, bringing you another video. And I honestly cannot believe this timeline I'm in, because in this video, I am aiming to get Modern Warfare fixed. Yeah, Modern Warfare is in a terrible state. If you go to the subreddit, you'll see just tons of threads talking about the bugs and stuff, and I'll leave a link to all the bugs caused by the most recent Warzone Pacific integration update thing. It made Vanguard worse, the new update. It made Cold War worse. It bugged some things out in that game, but it completely butchered Modern Warfare. And look, guys, I'm not the biggest fan of Modern Warfare, but you know what I am a fan of? I'm a fan of you guys not getting ripped off, and the Call of Duty community not getting ripped off. And just because I don't like Modern Warfare and I've hated on it for the past 2 years, it does not mean I want to see it in an unplayable state. I hated it because of the dumb decisions made by the developers as far as gameplay mechanics go, but by the end of everything, it worked very well. It was a very stable game. And that stability has been completely crushed, and it's not fair to you guys who actually like Modern Warfare. We need to do something, and I'm just gonna say, I think the hashtag people are using is hashtag FixMW. Use that wherever you want, use that on Twitter or whatever. Make your voices heard here, because this is complete bullshit. Modern Warfare is currently selling for the full price of $60. The last time I checked, digital and physical copies, by the way, $60. A $60 game should not have these problems in multiplayer this early on. Modern Warfare 2019 came out in 2019. You know, it still has a lot of life left in it, and there's some people that prefer it over Vanguard, and they prefer it over Cold War. And I can see why. You know, it's a different experience than both of those games. This is inexcusable. I covered what they broke in the last video I made. I will just put it up on screen here, and this screenshot's not even all of it. I couldn't even fit all of it on the screenshot that I took yesterday. It's that much. When I say the game is unplayable right now, that's not hyperbole. I'm not saying that for effect. I can say that for effect with Vanguard. Vanguard's playable, it's just broken. Like, you can boot it up and you can play it, but it's broken. Modern Warfare is literally unplayable the last time I checked. I think some sort of update came out today which may have accidentally fixed something. I don't actually know. I don't have the game installed because I don't feel like having a 300 gigabyte albatross on my Xbox Series X hard drive right now. Or should I say IW8 ship? They even messed up the name of the game. I think they fixed that today, but it just goes to show how little care went into this update. It just was not tested at all. It was not tested. It was shut out at the end of the year for Christmas so they could get their year-end profits and please their shareholders. What little are left, because the stock prices are plummeting. They are going down, down. Like that Fallout Boy song. I still don't know what the fuck that guy says. Going down, down, going bim bim bam. I don't know, man. I seriously don't know. I don't even know if you guys know what I'm talking about. Is that an old reference? Am I showing my age here? Who knows? Anyway, guys, I am, I don't know. I'm just disappointed in this update as a whole. And if you think the laziness stops at IW8 ship and Modern Warfare getting butchered, I mean, this isn't a big deal, but I still find it funny. We have Killbox version 2. If you guys don't know what Killbox is, Killbox was a playlist that Sledgehammer put out when Vanguard came out, right? It just said Killbox. There's no description on what it was. I still don't know what the fuck it was. I tried to figure it out. People would ask me what it was. I just replied with Killbox. I don't know. People would play it. They don't know. Nobody knows. I kind of wish they'd bring it back. It was like the only funny thing about the game. The only entertaining thing about Vanguard. But that came back again with Radar. Radar. Yeah. What game mode is it? You know? What's the player limit? Like, what's going on here? What game modes are in this? Just Radar. Paradise. Okay, what game modes? Just paradise. Just so lazy. Just type something out. How did they fuck up the title? I just want to bring this up again. IW8 ship. What is that? It sounds like an edgy SoundCloud band, man. Like a future Post Malone type rapper that's coming out. In fact, that's my new name. I'm making a SoundCloud right now. IW8 ship. Look for my album to drop on the 31st of December called I Wanna Suplex Joe Sekot. Actually, I'm sparing Joe Sekot because his baby, Modern Warfare, has been decimated by these careless devs and this shitheel publisher, and I won't stand for it. I want this game to be fixed because guess what, man? Money doesn't grow on trees. Some people don't have a lot of money. They have to spend their money very selectively. If you drop $60 plus tax on Modern Warfare and you get that for Christmas, maybe you want that game for Christmas. It's still relevant. It still has players. Maybe you want that instead of Vanguard. Maybe you want that instead of Cold War. Should I say Vantard and Cold Sore? They suck. I mean, I'm not a huge fan of Modern Warfare. I'm really not. You guys know that. But, like, the game works, as far as I know. Or it did work. It's more than I can give for Vanguard. Cold War works now, but the game puts me to fucking sleep. So, I don't know. If someone actually got Modern Warfare and that's all they have and they can't return it for some reason, or maybe they bought it, they opened it, they're playing it, and they can't return it before Christmas, and then this update happens, oh, it's just frustrating all around. It's frustrating all around, and I would hate for someone to actually be in that scenario. I just said, I would hate to be in that scenario myself. But here's the thing, okay? Here's the thing. I'm gonna get into this kind of conspiracy theory bit of the video now, because I do want to talk about this, and it is relevant. This guy on Reddit says, do you think all these issues with Modern Warfare have something to do with the 20 fired QA at Ravensoft 2 days before the update? It upset everyone there to the point the others staged a walkout. I mean, 2 days before the update and 2 weeks before Christmas, you fire these people who've been working on this forever. Maybe none of them threw a wrench in the machine, but could you honestly blame them if they did? Someone else I saw on Reddit said that this could be intentional. Like, they're intentionally messing up Modern Warfare because maybe it just has better player retention than Cold War and Vanguard, and they want to maybe force you to kind of buy the new game. Like, it honestly would not surprise me. I would not put it past them. Activision are scumbags at the end of the day. This is the same company that sexually harasses women again. Puts this insane, gross crunch time on their devs year after year. People are walking out left and right. The CEO, Bobby Kotick, is not without his controversy. He's very controversial right now, and they're asking for him to just step down entirely. It's just a mess. It's a complete mess. I want Call of Duty to be the Call of Duty that I know and love. I want them to release a complete functioning game that is enjoyable. I want them to go back to the roots and keep it simple. I don't want to see bad PNG overlays that you're trying to sell 12-year-olds. I don't want to see packet burst, games launching incomplete, updates that don't fix anything and actually make problems worse. I can't even play Vanguard right now. I tried to play earlier. You know what happened? I lost aim assist because they broke that somehow. I lost aim assist at random, trying to play radar. I got killed by a guy, glitched in the rock in radar. And then the game kicked me and gave me this and said I don't own Vanguard. Motherfucker, I wish I didn't own Vanguard. You guys want to give me a refund? I'll take it. I got enough gameplay stocked up to last me the next several months. I'll get it on one of your stupid sales because I know the game's selling like shit. We're selling Call of Duty in the UK for the past 14 years. We're selling Call of Duty in the UK for the past 14 years. I'm still wanting to see hard sales numbers. People are touting that, oh, it's the best-selling game of the week, but I haven't seen hard numbers. People are touting that it's the best-selling game for the past month or something on PlayStation, but the competition was Battlefield 2042, which was also broken and released, and GTA Trilogy, which was not broken, but not handled with care. Had a lot of things wrong with it, a lot of weird visual things wrong with it, mainly. So, it's like, I don't know which one's the least bad, like which is the least bad thing to come out at this point. I want to see hard data, hard numbers, but guys, I'm running out of time here. This is inexcusable, and I really, really hope that this gets fixed. I'm going to keep bringing it up ad nauseum until it is fixed, because you guys deserve a working Call of Duty. If you're a Modern Warfare fan, you deserve to be able to play your own game and not have to be forced to buy Vanguard, which, by the way, is not that much better. We're like a sneeze away from that game being in Modern Warfare state of complete unplayability. I'm not kidding. The game resembles an alpha build right now. Oh, and speaking of, here's the John Cena invisible skin. I think that still persists after the most recent update. This gameplay is old, but it still stands. I'm out of time though, guys. Let's get this game fixed. I'm gonna keep at it until I hear something. I'm not gonna let him get away with this. And I will catch you guys in the next one. I want to suplex Joe Sekhot into a working Modern Warfare 2019. Peace out, guys.